بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Pay attention. Leave this from your hand. Excuse me. We need to talk about something very important today. Stop. Stop. There is something called tarbiya, discipline. Anybody know what discipline mean?
Yes, sir.
Stop. I said stop. I'm talking, so you're supposed to listen. Okay? Yes. Yes.
Oh, this one is when you do something and you gotta get consequences for it.
Okay. Discipline to learn behavior, to learn the proper discipline, the proper adab, the proper mannerism, how to behave. Especially if you are Muslim, especially if you are in the house of Allah, the mosque. How somebody can be making salah and saying to the other person, shut up. This is not a manner. This is not behavior. When you come in here, number one, you come in for discipline, for to learn the proper behavior before learning what to say. It's not about how much you memorize. People, when people see you, they don't know what kind of degree you got, what kind of car you're driving. The people see the way how you behave, the way how you act. The people see how you behave and say, he's a bad boy or a bad girl. I'm talking. Part of discipline, when somebody talking, you look at him, not people. Looking everywhere. When somebody, a teacher, as there is a discipline, proper behavior, proper way of using things. When you're in the classroom, as example, there is a proper way to behave in the classroom. When you are in the mosque, there is a different way how to behave. When you're talking with the people, there is a way to behave. This is very important. If we did not have akhlaq, proper behavior, proper discipline is too bad. There is a proper way to sit in the mosque. There is a proper way to make salah. There is a proper way when you go, you come to the mosque. As example, don't leave your shoes on the ground. There is a shoe shelf there. Somebody come in rushing to catch the salah, and they will step on the shoes, and after this, they may be hurt themselves. Because we live in it. There is a proper way, okay, that when you want to talk, when you see somebody older than you, we need to learn this. It's so bad. You in the prayer, in the mosque, and you're saying to somebody, shut up, shut up. This is too bad. When your teacher is talking, you're supposed to be listening, paying attention. Not to be playing with anything, not even your clothes. We Muslims have, number one about Muslims, that they behave well. If you don't behave well, this is too bad. This is too bad. You hear me, everybody?
I'm here, sir. Yes, sir.
Proper behavior when you're sitting in the mosque, as example, you don't sit down and stretch your legs in front of your teacher or the imam. You fold your legs. You sit in a proper way. You don't put the Quran in the floor and your foot beside the Quran. This is not manner. We have to learn. And you have to pay attention. Yes. This is a proper way. He wants to talk. He raises his hand. He doesn't start talk like this. This is called behavior. What discipline. Go ahead.
What if a sandwich grew lazy and walked away?
If what?
If a sandwich.
No.
Walked away.
Let him express himself.
What if the sandwich grew legs and walked away?
Okay, can somebody translate to me, please? I'm sorry.
He's making a joke.
What he's saying?
What if a sandwich get a leg and walk away?
If the sandwich get a leg, we tell you how to behave with the sandwich when he get a leg. Let the sandwich get the leg first and we'll tell you what to do it. Okay? As a proper, all right. Okay? Okay? And the proper behavior also, that when people serious and talking about something important, that we don't make jokes. Okay? We're taking the subject out what we're talking about. We're talking about how to behave. Okay? I like the behavior of this young man, young boy. I like the behavior of this young boy. I like the behavior of most of you. Yes?
My brother been saying shut up when we were doing the Quran.
Astaghfirullah. This not good. This not good. But maybe he doesn't know. Next time he will know. Okay? So remember now, we have to have a good behavior with your teachers, with your parents, when you come to the mosque, when the teacher is talking in the class. We have to learn. If you don't know, you ask. But you could not be doing like this. People making salah and you be running outside and making disturbance to the people. Alaykum as-salam.
Assalamu alaykum. I think what the imam is saying, it should really be directed also to the parents, not only the kids.
Jazakallah khair.
The parents who brought these kids here.
Inshallah. And it is good opportunity when you come into the mosque and when you leave in the mosque, you have time to be with your children because you are in the van or in the car. This is a moment that you remind them because as a children, we forget sometimes, okay? Or maybe we did not go to the mosque except once a week. So from 1 week to another week, we forget. So in our way, coming to the mosque will be nice that we remind the children that this is a mosque, this is a place for prayer. We are not supposed to be running there. We are not supposed to be jumping on each other, play fighting, all these things. So anyway, inshallah, we're going to ask Brother Mahmoud and Sister Afroz that they make sure part of the curriculum on the weekend Islamic school, that they talk to children about the proper behavior and how to behave and how to listen and you have control over yourself. But people will respect you when you show respect. When you don't show respect, nobody cares for you. Nobody wants to even talk to you. Remember this, okay? We'll see you next week. Yes. They are not supposed to fight, Ferris, okay? There is no need for fight, okay? We are not supposed to be fighting, okay? We have to be nice to each other as much as we can, all right? Now we save some question to next week, inshallah. Is this possible?
Sure.
All right, thank you very much. Don't rush to the door. Take your time. There's no need for rushing and running.
Mom, I need to say something to you. What if a banana and chicken, those two foods come together and there would be a banana, a chicken, would you eat it or not?
Do I eat what, the banana or the chicken?
You would eat protein and something, both things mixed together.
Okay, thank you.